Hey guys, we are on playlist three. So if you've gotten to this point, hopefully you've gotten everything done from playlist one and two. If you haven't finished playlist two yet, then you need to be working on that before you move on to this playlist. So to start with, this is underneath playlist three on Google Classroom. That's where you'll find that. It looks like this. This week for you guys is a little interesting, and I'll get into that here in a second. But basically, on Monday, you're going to take the M&M Bell work form like you guys did last week. That's on Google Classroom, same place you found the exit ticket. Then you're going to actually put some vocabulary words in your tracker, and you're going to do that by using this presentation. And then when you're done with that, because tomorrow on Tuesday is a whole class day, then I want you to practice your morphemes for the week. But I don't foresee you having a lot of time at the end to be able to do that. But if you do have time, go for it. Also, it's important to note that one of our goals this week is that you will ace your morphemes quiz on Friday. That's your hint that you are actually going to be quizzed on these morphemes on Friday. It says it right there. So just be aware of that. The other thing that you are going to be, the other skill or goal that you guys should have is that you can pull out the five W's of an H in a text. And that's what we're going to do on Tuesday. It's whole class. You're going to read for 7 minutes at the beginning of class. When the timer goes off, together we are going to review the thieves model or the strategy, and then we're going to look at our first article of the week. You are then, after we get that all pulled up, you are going to write on the question for the week, or the weekly question that aligns with your social studies. How did early people change the way they interact with the environment over time? So again, you're going to be doing that. And then we're going to do that with article one, and then I'm briefly going to go through five W's and an H with you. And then it says even here that the five W's and an H worksheet is on Google Classroom. I'm going to go over here, five W's and an H worksheet, and then this is where I'm going to fill out that information on article one for the week. Wednesday is on your own. You're reading for 7 minutes. When you get done with that, you're going to be doing some morpheme practice. So that could be 5 minutes, that could be 10 minutes, just so that you feel more comfortable with the morphemes, because again, you're going to be tested on Friday. You are going to then finish article one, so you're actually going to read the rest of it, and finish it up, and then complete the questions and the writing assignment for article one. So that's Wednesday. And then Thursday, you'll have 7 minutes of reading. You will practice your morphemes. Again, that could be 5 minutes. You will be doing a vocabulary lesson. And then you will also be, this is why I said this week is kind of an interesting week for you guys, because you're going to be doing a second article. And this article is on a different topic. So the first one aligned with social studies. This week, it will align with the world's biggest issue. And we'll get more into that next week. But you'll read your second article. And then, yeah, you'll read your second article on Thursday. And then on Friday, you'll read 7 minutes from your library book. You'll finish reading that article. And then I also put in red so that you guys were very aware of this. You are not only are going to be quizzed on your morphemes this week, but I'm also going to actually look at and grade the thieves knowledge check. So if you go to Google Classroom where it says it is, I want you to fill out both of these documents, so the five W's and an H and the thieves. But what I'm going to be grading is this right here, the thieves reading strategy. And I even included a rubric. So for each one of these, you get 2 points, so it's 14 points total. If you don't do it, or if I can tell you don't understand what, like for example, the title is on the th in the thieves strategy, then you'll get a zero. If I can tell that you know what it is, but maybe you didn't give me as much information as I had hoped or was expecting, or I know that you didn't go as deep as you could, then you will get a one. And then if you really fill out the template to like with all of the information that you need, you'll get two. So again, it's showing understanding that you know what the title is, what the heading, introduction, all of the above looks like. So that's the rubric. And if you have any questions about it, please let me know. And so that is going to be, and then at the very end of class on Friday, hopefully you guys get to this, but you take the morphemes quiz that's linked there. So if you guys have any questions over anything that is on this playlist, please do not hesitate to ask. That's why I'm here.